I work for AT&T as a test manager, and as a part time, I used to do this training activity from morning 7:30 to 9. Always a batch will be there, and one batch on weekend. This is my regular activity, what I used to do normally. This is all about my personal activity. And coming to the classes here, what we will be already I would have said you over phone what are the things what I will be giving in a brief of 1 to 2 minutes. Just I will repeat that once again. Here we will be learning completely on Selenium. If you don't know manual also, no need to worry, I will guide you that. It's apart from this class. Is it mandatory to learn manual before learning automation or something? Nothing it is mandatory. A little bit of manual is necessary. That I will let you know what. If you are not aware with manual, I'll just give you a small guidance on how to learn manual also. And I'll give you some more tips and tricks on manual as well. That is just aside of these topics, whatever I am going to teach you here. And how many days it is going to take? It will take almost 1 month to 40 days to complete this course. Daily it will be the 7:30 sharp I will start the classes for sure. And it will be up to 9 o'clock. Just before 5 minutes, like 9 o'clock, I will leave the class. And as I said, for 40 days of class will be there. After each and every days of your class, whatever we are going to take here, I will give you some homeworks. If you are doing those homeworks, that is more than sufficient to work as an experience going further, because whatever I teach here will be completely on real time. I will give you the real time scenarios here. That is why I said don't decide anything till half of your course. Slowly to pitch into your Selenium, it will take at least 5 or 6 more days. Until that, we will be learning basics and prerequisites of this Selenium. And without knowing the prerequisites like others, we should not directly jump into Selenium and start learning. First we can learn prerequisites properly, then we can start learning this Selenium, so that it will be proper enough. That is a process how you have to learn. And after finishing each and every days of class, I will record the class and I will give the video of the class also. And at the end of the course, I will be making you to work on one real-time project as well, so that you will be, most of them here you will be trying as an experience. I know that. I mean 90% of the, only 10% you will be trying as a fresher. As a fresher level also you can. And you will ask, sir, I don't know anything about Java. I am very new to programming. I am from biotech. I am from civil. No need to worry. Many of them from the previous batch also have learned. If you want to meet the previous batch, after 9 o'clock they will come here. One or two students will come here to prepare their resumes and go. You can check with them. They will be non-IT people also. Few of them will be non-IT people. They are learning, and most of them they are working now. It's nothing related that you should have a particular background in your college curriculum or nothing like that. I'll be guiding you everything here, including the basics of Java. From starting point of the installation, I will guide you here. And after completing the course, I'll prepare resume for you, and I will tell you how to get the calls through Naukri. I'll help you all the ways also to get the job. And after, even after getting the job also, if you need any help, you can come and seek the help from me. All those things will be given here. And throughout the course, daily bring your notes. I'll be giving notes to you. Might be today and tomorrow you'll not have, a proper notes. From Monday's class onwards, fully I will be giving the notes also. Whatever I dictate here, it will be given as a notes. And I have written a book on Selenium. I will be providing that book also to you. These things, only first 2 days of your classes will be not that much important. From Monday's class onwards, everything, each and everything is important. Today's, tomorrow's class is also a part of Selenium only, but it's an outdated one. First we learn this outdated one, see what are the drawbacks of this, and we can go to the updated one. That is Selenium IDE, which we are going to learn, and some basics which are not necessary for to work. And this is all about. Is there any other doubts what you have? Any doubts? Before starting. Joshna, Raji. This will be the same timings, no changes in the timings. And one last weekend I will be taking. One weekend I will be taking the class. Because I will be taking the real-time project where I cannot split that into 1.5 hour. It takes a minimum of 4 hour stretch continuously. That I will take on the weekend. And Saturday and Sunday. Both the days. Saturday 4 hours and Sunday 4 hours I will take. One weekend will be there. That is on last weekend. After some 2 weeks I will let you know on which weekend I will be taking based upon our speed of how we learn. Okay. Start doing your homeworks regularly. That is more than sufficient to I mean workers and experienced going further. Complete training will be on real time here. Some noise from Joshna, I guess. Please mute your mic. If you want, you can switch to online also if you are coming from too far. Most of them, those who are coming here, I think you are very nearby only. If you are coming from too far, you can switch to online also if you need. Or else if you...
Yes.
Yes, you can take online also, not a problem. But don't come and call at 7:30 in the morning and tell that, no sir, I am going to send you a Skype request now. If you want to do, on the previous day itself, make sure that you should have a test connection once at least. Call me and test whether you are able to hear properly and connections are proper enough on the previous day, and the next day you can join. Okay. As soon as you wake up morning at 7:25, you will feel that I cannot go to class. Okay, let's call him and connect online. Don't have that thought, please. And morning, I'm not feeling well. I'll be getting those messages regularly. I'm not feeling well today. Can you please send me the video after? Anyhow, I'll send you the video. It's not a problem after completing the class. But it is suggestible to come to the classes here. Okay. Now, let's start with Selenium. Before going into Selenium, first let us see what is meant by testing, what is meant by manual, what is automation, then we can jump into Selenium. What is meant by testing, first of all? Why we need to test an application? Why can't we release it directly? Anyhow, when developer develops a product, he will not close his eyes and he will not develop. He will have one round of testing and he will give it to us. Why we need to test that as a tester? Best product standards, human errors, meets the business requirements. Yes.
If someone is developing the code, they pretty much confident on their code and they are less.
They think that their work is done or not. Their work is. Yeah.
I am doing proper job.
Yeah. Yes. As a tester, what we do is, we think in the perspective of end user and we will test it. What developer does is, whether his job is done or not. For example, if they tell to develop a text box, he will check whether the text box is developed or not. But we will test in different way, we will try to crack that and we will check whether that we are able to crash that application or something like that. Okay. Once we test it, again, every day, why we need to keep on testing that? Once it is done, it is done. Regression. Not performance. Regression is okay. Not because of performance. Why we need to test that daily? Once we test it, once we test and deliver it to the end, customer, why we need to test that product daily, in a daily basis or a weekly once like that? Maintenance part, okay. There will be some upgrade to the product or a software always. They'll keep on updating that. They will add some new functionalities to that. When they add the new functionalities, existing functionalities should not break up. Am I correct? That's why it is mandatory that whenever updates is going on, we have to keep on, we need to keep on checking the software, whether that is going correct or not. That's why always testers also will have a job. Once it is tested, it is not that our job is done. We have to keep on testing that again and again. I'm working in a company called Google and I have a product called Gmail. Gmail is a product of Google, right? And to test the Gmail product, there are some 1,000 test cases to test. There are 1,000 test cases to test. How many test cases can be executed by one manual testers per day? How many test cases we can test per day as per industrial standards? Depends upon the scenario and complexity. On an average scenario, average complexity we can take? 5 to 7. 50, yeah, but that is quite a challenging task. 50 in the sense, if it is a small test cases, we can test 50. What you are telling for 7 to 8, if it is too difficult test cases, then it is 5 to 7. On an average, as per industrial practice, we can test 30 test cases per day. That is the industrial standards what we have. In that case, to test the Gmail product, I have some 1,000 test cases. How many employees do I require to test the Gmail every day? Around 30 plus, 30 to 35 employees are required to test the Gmail product. If that Gmail is going to withstand for next 20 years or 30 years, I want to hire the 20 to 30 employees for next 20 to 30 years until unless the Gmail product exists, right? Is it a decent job to hire 30 employees? Not. For sure, to hire 2 or 3 employees, I'm struggling for more than 1 month, to be honest. If I want to hire 30 employees and withstand that, it is not that easy job. What we can do in that case is, we have the 1,000 test cases with us, right? If you automate those 1,000 test cases and keep it with us, only one employee can test those 1,000 test cases and maintain those 1,000 test cases. And he can test all the 1,000 test cases every day. Okay, how to do that automation? That is what we are going to learn here. If you do automation, see, normally if you have the 1,000 test cases, and if even though if you have 1,000 test cases and 30 employees, if you tell them to test from morning till evening, they will take time to test that. But if you have automation test cases, right, we can test within 1 hour and we can submit the results. We can make the 1,000 test cases to run in 50 different systems and collect the results from the 50 different systems and submit the results. That all we will learn here, how to do that. We can save the time, manpower, everything will be saved if we go through automation. How do we achieve that here? That is what we are going to learn. There are different tools in market where we can do automation. There are different tools in the market. What are the tools what you know? QTP, good. Why you are here? Selenium. Selenium is also an automation tool, right? Okay, any other? SOAP UI, good. JMeter is not an automation tool, it's a performance tool. Appium, it's okay. It's a mobile application automation tool. Cucumber is not an automation tool, it's a BDD approach. We will be learning Cucumber also here at the last class. Yeah, your name? Rashmi, yeah, come and take this. You have there or else here, anywhere you can come and take this. Okay, what are the other tools what you know? Perfecto, yes. I heard about that, but I have never worked on this. There is a tool called Renorex where I have worked on this tool also. There is a tool called Test Complete. Hello? Ekkada first floor lo. Lopliki ra class lo vachukochu. Kochu. పార్కస్ దాంట్లోనే లోపల రా, దాంట్లోనే కేర్ అని ఇన్ఫర్మేటిక్స్ కూడా ఉండేది. లోపల థర్డ్ రూమ్లో కూర్చు కూర్చో, క్లాస్లో ఉన్నా. టెస్ట్ కంప్లీట్. ఎనీ అదర్ టూల్స్ వాట్ యు నో? దెర్ ఇస్ అ టూల్ కాల్ ఓట్స్ బై అరకల్. లేకుంటే ఇక్కడ యూ కెన్ టేక్ దీస్ సీట్స్ అస్ వెల్. వీ హ్యావ్ ఫ్యూ మోర్. ఓకే, there are tens of tools available in the market. There are tens of tools available in the market. Okay. In this, everyone, you will be aware with this QTP and Selenium. You will not be aware with the other tools normally, right? Even not only you, those who are working into automation also will be aware with these two tools only. Why? Because those are the biggest competitors in the market. The other tools are used by few companies. For example, OATS is used by only Oracle. They won't outsource it somewhere. There is a tool called Rational Robot by IBM. Sriharsha, it's your internet problem, Sriharsha. Don't send IM messages to me. There are different two. I mean, few tools are developed by their own companies and they will use it. They won't outsource it. In that case, you no need to know about those tools and all. But QTP and Selenium, it's outsourced to the market, and they are using very widely. And they are using very widely. Now, if you take the statistics of error, oh, sorry. If you take the statistics of around 2004 to 2005, you see, QTP is the masters who have invented the tool called automation, first of all. Earlier, they don't know what is meant by automation itself in software industry. QTP is the one, first one. HP is the company which has invented this QTP in the year 1998. In the year 1998, they have invented a tool called QTP. And in the year 2000 onwards, it came into the market and they have started using this automation tool. But in the year 2004, Selenium has introduced a new tool called Selenium has introduced into the market by ThoughtWorks, and everyone have started using Selenium. There are a lot of advantages with Selenium when compared with QTP that we will see it after this session. Now, when we take the statistics of around 2004 to 2005, 70% of the companies, 70% of the companies are using Joseph. 70% of the companies are using QTP at the time. 20% of the companies are using Selenium, and 10% of the companies are using other tools in the year 2004 to 2005. That is the overall statistics. But when we take the current statistics, right? When we take the current statistics, 70% of the companies are using Selenium now, and 20% of the companies are using QTP, and 10% of the companies are using other tools. See, there is a drastic change in the usage of tools in this span of 8 to, this is the year 2016 to 2017. There is a drastic change of usage of tools in the market, right? Yeah, I started at 7:30 itself. Where are you? You can come and join, not a problem. You can come and join. Yeah. Okay. See, there is a drastic change, and we come to know here by the usage of tools in the market in this span of 8 to 10 years, sorry, 10 to 12 years, there is a tough competition between QTP and Selenium. That is what we have analyzed by the usage of tools in the market in this span of 10. If you want, you can take down this. I am going to go to the next step now. Next, we are going to see the difference between QTP and Selenium. What is the difference between QTP and Selenium? Why everyone have started using Selenium? Why not QTP? Why can't we go with QTP itself? QTP is the masters, those who have invented automation strategy, first of all. Okay, now we are going to see about the difference between QTP and Selenium now. If you want, you can take down this next. See, this is, today is the last theory class what you will be learning. You will not be having any theory class going further. Completely, it will be practical from tomorrow onwards. Since it is an introduction class, I am just giving a little bit theory for you. You will not have any theory. Just 5% theory will be there. 95% it will be completely practical here. Because theory doesn't help you to search a job, or else to crack the interviews, or else to work. If you want theory, you can go through Google itself and you can learn it. No need to come here, first of all. Take down if you want. Next. Let's see about the difference between QTP and Selenium. Selenium and QTP. What are the differences, what you know, between Selenium and QTP? Why, see, there are, nearly 70% of the companies, those who are using QTP, has migrated to Selenium, right? Why this changes has occurred? There are some advantages with Selenium. That's why everyone are migrating. What are those advantages? What you know the difference between Selenium and QTP? Selenium is an open source tool and QTP is a license. What is open source and what is license? Yes. To use QTP, we have to pay some amount. To use Selenium, we no need to pay amount. Don't tell that what is the difference between open source and paid in this. We can download it for free of cost and do that. Downloading, anyone can download. When you are installing, at the last step of installation, it will ask a 16-digit product key. If you want to buy that 16-digit product key for QTP, you want to pay some amount. Earlier it is 1,20,000 rupees, Indian rupees, for one system for 1 year. But now they have slashed down the prices to 32,000 for one system for 1 year, QTP license. That too for 1 year, that too for one system. Whereas Selenium, we buy it for free of cost and we can use it for free of cost. No need to purchase, just download, install, it will not ask any product key. That we will see here. The Selenium is a open source tool. Whereas this QTP is a paid tool. I'll give you time to take down this. Just listen. You can take down later. Selenium and QTP. Any other difference what you know?
QTP is standalone.
Standalone. What the advantage if it is standalone?
Difference.
Okay. We can see advantage, the advantages and difference as well. So see, when they ask the in interview, if you get a question like this, right, what is the difference between Selenium and QTP apart from open source? That is how they will ask. Everyone will tell the same answer. It became routine. That's why you can go through interview questions and answers and you can check that as well. They will ask, can you tell me the difference between Selenium and QTP apart from open source and paid? Then you have to answer. There are many more points what you can tell. Yeah, someone is telling. Good. The Selenium supports all the operating systems, whereas this QTP supports only Windows. It doesn't support Linux. It supports only Windows. You can take down later. I will give you time. Just listen. Good. The Selenium support, if you know Java code, you can start writing the Selenium. If you know Python, you can start writing the Selenium. If you know Ruby, you can start writing the Selenium. If you know C#, you can start writing the Selenium. If you know any one of these languages, you can start writing the Selenium code. Whereas if you want to work with QTP, must ensure you should know VB scripting. You should know VB scripting. Any other differences? That's a drawback. We can see the drawbacks later. First, we can see the advantages. Good. That's also a difference. Good. Any other differences? There are a lot more. There are three more still. See, this Selenium supports all the major browsers. Major browsers. Like Firefox, Chrome, IE, Opera, Safari, all these browsers it supports. Whereas QTP supports only IE browser. The latest version of QTP supporting Mozilla, all those browsers. But again, if you want to work with those, you want to buy a separate plugins from QTP. Again, plugins cost separate. 5,000 or 6,000 one plugin. They keep on charging for that. Is it the correct way? No. See, I buy it for... Yeah. XPath. QTP doesn't follow XPath concept.
Selenium.
Okay.
So in Firefox, we go to the Firefox and we identify the XPath.
In Chrome also we have. We'll see very clearly about that. For 3 to 4 days, we are going to completely learn about XPath topics.
Okay.
We will learn. It will take at least 3 to 4 days to learn only XPath topics here. Okay. I didn't give you the syllabus. Might be tomorrow or day after tomorrow, I will give you the syllabus also to you. Yeah. No, not necessary to know anything about QTP. No need. This is your syllabus. Today we will be seeing the basics of testing and automation. That's it, nothing beyond that. From might be after 3 days of class, we will be starting learning about the expert topic for 3 to 4 days completely. Day by day topic, it is clearly given. I'll give you this later. No worries about this. What are the topics, what we are going to cover, all those things. Okay. We'll see about that also in difference between QTP and Selenium. Why we have to use only XPath, all those things also. Just give me some more time. Any other doubts apart from that? What you have? No. Your name? Indrani. Any other doubts apart from that? Apart from that element locators. We'll see about that now. See, I buy it for free of cost and I have these many advantages. Why people will start using this QTP? No, right? No. The size of this Selenium is just 28 MB. The size of this Selenium is just 28 MB. 28 MB. Whereas the size of this QTP is 1.5 GB. GB. 1.5 GB. Whereas if you want to work with QTP, right, you should have a minimum of 2 GB of RAM. You should have a minimum of 2 GB RAM and you should have the basic configuration of the system. Whereas to work with Selenium, right, if you have old Pentium 1 machine, can you open that a little bit? Yeah, pull it completely. It's suffocating. If you want to work with Selenium, right, if you have old Pentium 1 machines which has 256 MB of RAM, that is more than sufficient. If you are able to install Java, then you can start working with Selenium also. You no need to have the latest configuration with the i7 processor. See, if you people, you might be planning to buy a laptop to learn Selenium. Don't buy a higher configuration laptop with 70,000 rupees and which has Hi-5 and good graphic card, all those. Nothing is necessary. If you have old machine, Pentium 1 machine also, that is more than sufficient to work with Selenium. That's an advantage again. Next. These are the advantages of Selenium with QTP. I will come back to these advantages of Selenium and QTP. I am going to guide you one general topic. What just Indrani had asked. We'll talk about this after this difference between Selenium and QTP. See, if execute? No, both takes similar time almost. Whereas adjusting the time is very easy in Selenium. Whereas adjusting the time in QTP is quite difficult. I have a website called xyz.com. I have a website called xyz.com. I have username pass username text box. I have a password box. And I have a login button. Manually, I want to verify whether login is working fine or not. Manually, I want to verify whether login is working fine or not. How will you manually verify whether login is working fine or not? Where will you enter the username and password? How will you get that? First you need to open the URL, right? Where will you open the URL? First you need to open the browser, right? First start from the beginning. First open the browser. Then open the URL. Then enter the username. Where? Can I enter the username here? No, I want to enter the username in the username text box. Enter the password in the password box. Then click on login button. Okay, after opening the browser, after opening the URL, enter the username in the username text box. Enter the password in the password box. Then click on login button. Those are the steps what you will be doing. See, to do any, for if I want to enter the username in the username text box, first I want to identify the username text box and perform some typing operation there. Identify this password box, perform some typing operation there. Identify this login button and perform some click operation. Are you getting this?
to do any for to do any automation activity to do any automation activity first I need to identify the element, and second I need to perform action on it. For example, if I have a checkbox here, if I want to click on the checkbox, first I need to identify the element, then I want to perform action. If I have a radio button, if I want to click on the radio, identify the element and click on that radio button, that is perform action on that radio button. If I have a forget your password link, if I want to click on that link, identify that element and perform some action. To do any automation activity, not only by using Selenium, with any tool, you will be doing only two steps. These two steps, whatever you are going, I am telling this, identifying the element, and that is what you are going to learn for next 40 days of your class. Only these two steps you are going to learn, nothing beyond that. Whatever you learn will fall under any one of these steps. Okay. To identify the element, we will use a concept called element locators. Will you use a concept called element locators to identify the element? We'll use a concept called element locators. In Selenium, there are 8 element locators. In Selenium, there are 8 element locators. This we will see from Monday's class onwards. How? What about these element locators? See, what is the purpose of these element locators? What is the purpose of this element locator? To identify the element. Without identifying the element, I cannot perform the action. If you are not doing these things, we cannot do automation at all. To identify the elements, there are 8 different ways to identify the element. What are those in the sense? ID, name, link text. We'll see. It is getting split. There are 8 element locators available in Selenium that we'll see in detail about that element locators later. Okay. There are 8 element locators. I'll give you time to take down all this, whatever I am writing here. You can take down later. There are 8 element locators available in Selenium, whereas in say QTP we have only one element locator called as object repository. Only one. If that one element locator fails to identify the element, I cannot automate that. I have to tell to the our manager that I cannot automate that scenario. Whereas in Selenium, if one of the element locator fails to identify the element, there is an alternative. There is an element locator called XPath. Through XPath, I can identify any element in a web page. There is all the possible ways are there to identify the element, and lot of chances are there to automate when compared with QTP. Okay, I buy it for free of cost, and I have these many advantages. Why people will go for QTP? Are you understanding this? Why this drastic change has been occurred in this span of 8 to 10 years? And most of them, those who are using QTP, has migrated to Selenium. That is the reason. But still, there are some drawbacks with Selenium. Some 20% of the companies are still using QTP, right? Why they are using? Are they fools to use? No. They might have some drawback. They might have found some drawbacks with Selenium. That is why still they are using this QTP. What are those drawbacks? What is the reason why they are using that? You said some difference just now, right? Web applications. Yes. Desktop and web applications. There are some drawbacks. See, since you came for Selenium class here, I am telling about Selenium. If you go for QTP, they will say some advantages with QTP also as well. But since you know the fact, you will ask only one question. Okay, if there are those many advantages, why not there are no openings on QTP? If you ask that question, they cannot answer. You know the fact. Right, and there are some drawbacks with Selenium also. What are those drawbacks we can see now? This Selenium supports only web applications, whereas this QTP supports both desktop and web applications. What is desktop applications? Applications and what is desktop? Some standalone applications are? Standalone applications are web applications are what? What is web application and what is desktop application? Can you give some examples for web applications? Don't tell me websites. What are those websites? Tell me. Give me some examples, I'm asking. What are those? Tell me. Flipkart, Myntra, Amazon, Gmail, Facebook, Jabong. All these things are web applications. Right. Can you give some examples for desktop applications? VLC Media Player, good. Calculator, Notepad, WordPad. All these things are desktop applications. Games. Some games are online again. We cannot tell all games. Some games. Okay. Yeah. See, anything which opens in a browser, anything which opens in a browser is a web application. All the other applications are desktop applications. This is very simple to answer, right? Anything which opens in a browser is a web application. Even browser itself is a desktop application. Browser itself is a desktop application. Anything which opens inside the browser is a web application. But nowadays, all the applications, since they are moving into cloud, all the applications are becoming web applications. Scarcity for web applications is becoming a lot. Demand for that is becoming a lot. Everyone, those who are developed, they develop either mobile applications or web applications. It is very less they are developing the standalone applications or desktop applications. Okay. This difference is there just before some 10 months. But now what these Selenium guys are doing is, now they are developing a new tool called Vinium. This is not released into the market yet officially. What is the purpose of this Vinium, in the sense, this Vinium tool is used to automate Windows-based desktop applications. It's an open source developed by Selenium again. If this comes into, we can use Vinium also. It is very easy to use also. I have worked on this. The beta versions are there. Trial softwares are there. You can use that. Officially, they have not released yet. If this Vinium comes into existence, right, we can automate Windows-based desktop applications also. In that case, why people will go for QTP? They have to go for open source. There is no other choice for them. Okay. In last batch, I have got a question. Sir, why they are... what is the advantage for them if they are developing the open source tool? It's just as a service they might do. Or else, they might get contributions from outside world to develop the software. You can go to Selenium. If you have too much money, you can go and contribute to them. Go to seleniumhq.org, donate. Somewhere you will have donate. Click on this donate. Use your credit cards or debit cards and donate if you have too much money. In that way, they will get lot and crores of donations. With that, they can develop and they can make outside world to use that. And because of that, there might be a lot of jobs which occurs. Now, when Selenium came into existence, you can see how many automation jobs have been. Right? It's a very great service. It is developed by a company called ThoughtWorks. Selenium is developed by a company called ThoughtWorks. They took that initiative and they are doing that now. Okay? These are the advantages of Selenium over QTP, and one disadvantage also we have found. But that's not a big drawback. Very soon they are going to overcome that disadvantage also. Any other disadvantages? Any tool, whatever the tool you learn, either it might be QTP, Selenium or NRX or Test Complete or whatever the tool, Perfecto or any tool, first you will start with the basics. You will do something called record and playback. First you will start with that, later on you will do the coding. Today or tomorrow we will be learning how to record and playback. We'll see the code, what is meant by automation first of all. Later on, we'll be going for the coding as well. Not only this tool, any tool when you learn, you will start with the basics of record and playback. When you are doing record and playback, Selenium does not record properly. Whereas QTP, it records properly. But in real time, in industry, no one uses this record and playback. It is not suggestible to use record and playback. Just you learn it today and tomorrow, whatever I teach you this record and playback, just learn it and trash it. You no need to practice that also again and again. But from Monday's topic onwards, whatever you learn, you have to practice, keep on repeatedly practicing that. But this is the, this record and playback is just an outdated one. No one will use that in real time. And you will not get any questions in interviews also, I am sure for that. But when you start any tool, it's a basic necessity to learn that so that it will be easy for you. You can understand what is meant by automation first. Later on, you can step into that. That is why you will be learning that. These are the advantages of... This is also a drawback, but it's not a big drawback because we will not be using this in real time anywhere. These two are the drawbacks, but it's not a big one. These are the advantages of Selenium over QTP. Have you understood this? Any doubts with this? Might be you will not be understanding a little bit on this element locators that you will see in detail about that going further. How many element locators are there? What are those? All those things. Okay, take down this into your notes. Joshna, Raji, Harsha, are you understanding what I'm telling? Is there any lag in the voice or something? Perfect enough. Okay. If you feel any difference between these online and offline class, please let me know so that I can... If there is any lag in the voice or internet connection problem or something. Wait, I will give you this also. This also I will display you. Just finish this first. Okay. Identifying the element, second point is performing action on it. Okay. Those are the goals of automation. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, here we can integrate with any of the tool. That is an inbuilt what you are getting, QTP with ALM. Here we can integrate this either with ALM or Jira or TestRail or any tool we can integrate. It's very easy to do that here. It's a customized one and that is a predefined one. Even I don't have much exposure with QTP. I just hardly worked for 6 months to 1 year. Nothing beyond. Okay, if you want, you can take down this also. Those. Take down this if you want. No need, because whatever I'm teaching, I'm recording and giving, right? Same thing, you can go home, open my video if you have any doubts, practice it, try to do that. No need to bring the laptops here. If you want, you can bring here, do it after completing the class. It will be free only here, no one will be sitting. You can sit and practice, we will provide you the internet also if you want. But during the class, no need to do anything. First, that's why what I said, attend for a few classes, you will come to know. Today is it necessary? Not. Tomorrow also after completing the class you will come to know whether it is necessary or not. Later on you can decide. Yes. Okay, next. We have saw the difference between Selenium and QTP. This I will give you the syllabus, might be tomorrow or Monday. Because I want a few others also to join. Once everyone joins I will. There are 3 to 4 people who will be joining. Now we are going to learn about Selenium. Anyhow, we are here to learn Selenium. Selenium is developed in the year 2004 by the company called ThoughtWorks. Do you know where this ThoughtWorks is located? Yeah.
Here in Bangalore. Lower office, here.
Yeah.
It was somewhere near this
download. Yeah, near Kormangla. Kormangla.
It is,
yeah, somewhere near to that only. That is where ThoughtWorks is located. Branch office headquartered in UK. There will be regular conferences which happens there in Kormangla, Bangalore, in ThoughtWorks. So that if you attend that, right, we will come to know the updates of Selenium. Every first Saturday or second Saturday, the conference will happen. If you want to book the tickets also, we can go to the seleniumhq.org and book the tickets there. And we can go and attend the conference there, and I will be attending there so that I will come to know what are the updates, what they are going to make in future, what they have made present, all those things we will be getting a clear picture.
We are coming from manual background, manual testing. So after 7-8 years of experience, we are shifting to Selenium.
Yes.
So in what level do you will be expecting this?
In that case, when you are trying for a job, right, you don't keep completely a 7 years into automation. Tell that I worked for first 3 years into manual and next 4 years into automation. How to crack the interview up to 4 years, I will be guiding you everything here in the classes. And what are the concepts? Don't go beyond 4 years. It is not advisable. Because even if I tell, people keep on doing that. No, sir, I'm very confident. You taught us very well. That's why I'll keep to 7 years. They will go there, fail and come back. They will ask why I fail. I said you to keep us 4 years. No, if you keep 7 years, I'll get more package. They'll think. Don't think like that. Don't be too cunning to do that. Okay. Keep it up to 4 years. I saw last batch also, one guy had 11 years of experience. I said to him, don't keep 11 years of experience. He said that first 3 years I have worked in manual and 7 years he have kept into automation. He keep on going to the interview and he's failing. Because they will ask questions to the managerial levels and it will be quite difficult for you to crack. Just keep up to 3 years or 4 years. All the knowledge required to that I will give you here. Okay. That is why, there are some other small tricks what I will be giving during the classes also. Don't answer like this, answer like in such a way like that. Because they will test, as soon as you go for the interview, they will test whether you are really experienced or fake. There are small tricks how we can identify that. Even I used to take interviews.
we have some tips and tricks how to do that. That also I will let you know. You should not tell answer like that. Don't tell in that way. Okay?
No, so that.
Okay.
As a QTP, he cracked the interview. I don't know, maybe 3 years, 4 years. After that, he couldn't perform.
That is not because his technical ability. It might be some other personal activities. He might be shifting to some other new tools. He might have a ability to learn new things, and he will be concentrating on new things by not updating into QTP. We should have updates always, or else somewhere you will fail. Even if I am not getting updated daily, I mean on a monthly basis or somewhere, right? For sure, after 6 months, my company will throw me out telling that you are not reaching up to the mark. This is not a one-day process. To enter into that, I will be guiding you everything here. But to sustain in the job, you have to do some hard work from your side also. It is nothing that 100% I can keep on giving you. Up to till date, I can update you and I can give it to you. Not beyond this. Okay. Now, Selenium is invented in the year 2004 and it is developed by the company called ThoughtWorks. And the scientist who have contributed for initiated this is Jason Huggins is the one who have developed this Selenium initially. Now, in Selenium, there are three components in Selenium. Selenium IDE, Selenium RC, and Selenium WebDriver. Selenium Grid is not a component that we can see later. It's not a, don't think that, sir, there is one more component called Selenium Grid. It's not a component. Selenium IDE, RC, and WebDriver. These are the three. In the year 2004, they have developed the Selenium IDE. That is nothing but Integrated Development Environment. Integrated Development Environment. It is developed in the year 2004. They have found some drawbacks with the Selenium IDE. We can see this Selenium IDE now. Okay, they have found some drawbacks in Selenium IDE, and in the year 2007, they have implemented Selenium RC, that is Selenium Remote Control. Again, they have found some drawbacks with the Selenium Remote Control, and in the year 2008, beginning and 2007 ending, they have implemented something called Selenium WebDriver. Even now, everyone are using Selenium WebDriver only. We are going to learn completely on Selenium WebDriver only here. Okay, these are the three components of Selenium what we have. And we will be widely learning about Selenium IDE. First, today and tomorrow we will complete Selenium IDE. It's a matter of 1 hour to learn Selenium IDE. Just see what are the drawbacks with this Selenium IDE. We can jump directly to Selenium WebDriver. What are the things which are there in RC are covered in WebDriver. And apart from that, some extra topics are there in Selenium WebDriver. That is what, if you learn Selenium WebDriver, RC is not necessary for you because that got outdated anyhow.
Okay.
That also is outdated, but we want to see, if you want to learn the Selenium WebDriver, some basic necessities are there what we have to learn in Selenium IDE. Directly we cannot learn that, that's why. You want to know what is meant by automation first of all. If you learn Selenium IDE, quickly we can learn what is meant by automation. Then we can slowly jump into Selenium WebDriver and see what are the drawbacks of that. And if you say, without learning this, directly if you learn WebDriver, if they ask, why can't you use Selenium IDE, you cannot tell the difference. You cannot tell the drawbacks of Selenium IDE. That's why we are going to learn that, just to see the drawbacks of that. That's why you just hardly spend 1 hour or half an hour, not beyond that. Okay, take down this if you have not taken down. Make it quick. I will let you know. Oops concepts is more than sufficient. People say that we need to learn more Java, nothing beyond that to work. And I will give you some documents also to learn from where to learn that. Some basic select queries what you have learned in few interviews they will ask, in few interviews they won't ask also. Very few interviews they will ask on the SQL also. That we will see on Monday's class. Will be covered here. Everything will be covered here. Today is just an introduction class, nothing beyond that. That is why I tell, come and attend at least some 30-40% of the course. Then only you will come to know the picture, outsketch at least, what you are going to learn. Later on you can decide. Until that, just keep on coming here,
follow my homeworks, do those things, that is more than sufficient. Next. Take the next heading as Selenium IDE. Python with Selenium has very less openings. Because we used to train earlier and most of the people are still searching for that Selenium with Python. That's why I don't suggest to use that. I have worked on that for 2 years, Selenium with Python. But demand for that is less when compared with Java with Selenium. You're going to learn about Selenium IDE now. It's not that difficult to learn these Java topics which are required to learn Selenium. Only few topics. Yeah. Selenium IDE. First we can see the installation of Selenium IDE. Installation of Selenium IDE. And later on we can see what is meant by the Selenium IDE and all those things. Leave some 3 to 4 lines of gap here. Then start taking Selenium IDE. Installation of Selenium IDE. The Selenium IDE, it is just a record and playback tool. Selenium IDE is just a record and playback tool. It supports only Mozilla Firefox browser. It supports only Mozilla Firefox browser. Okay, now let us see the. Don't take down any notes for installation of Selenium IDE. I'll give you clear notes. Just listen. How to see, I said Selenium supports all the browsers, right? But the Selenium IDE doesn't support all the browsers. It supports only Mozilla Firefox browser only. It supports only Mozilla Firefox browser. How to install this? Normally, when how you install any software like VLC Media Player or Winamp or any software, how will you install? Download the .exe file. Next, and install. Why you click on next? Even I don't know why we click on. Just keep on clicking on next, and do the installation. First time when you click on next, it will extract that, convert the jar file into normal files, search for setup file there. Like that, some or the other meaning will be there. We no need to worry about that. But installation of Selenium IDE is quite different. It is not like a routine software, how we install. This Selenium IDE is an add-on to the Mozilla Firefox browser. It is an add-on to the Mozilla Firefox browser. In that case, we should have Mozilla Firefox browser first. On top of Mozilla Firefox browser, we can install this Selenium IDE. We can install this Selenium IDE. How to install this? Open Mozilla Firefox browser first. Open Mozilla Firefox browser. Open Mozilla Firefox browser, go to seleniumhq.org, open Mozilla Firefox browser, go to seleniumhq.org, don't take down the notes, listen, I will give you notes for this. Open Mozilla Firefox browser, open seleniumhq.org, click on this download section, Here you have Selenium standalone server, Internet Explorer drive. Search for Selenium IDE subsection. Are you finding any Selenium IDE subsection? Yes or no? Yes. You have got Selenium IDE subsection, right? Under seleniumhq.org/download, click on download. You will go to seleniumhq.org/download. Under Selenium IDE, click on for Firefox. For Firefox. You will get this add to Firefox button. But it is telling that your version is not supporting. Okay, that's why I have an outdated version of Firefox browser. Okay, so that what I am going to do, go to the previous IDE versions. Go to the previous IDE versions.
here, come down somewhere, you will have add to Firefox button will be enabled. Okay, add to Firefox button is enabled. Click on add to Firefox button, click on install, click on restart. Now it will restart only the Mozilla Firefox browser. It will restart. Open seleniumhq.org, click on download, go to Selenium IDE subsection, click on previous IDE versions, click on add to Firefox button, install. That will be installed. Can you repeat, can you tell me once again how to install? Open Mozilla Firefox browser, go to seleniumhq.org, click on download, just a minute guys, then go to Selenium IDE subsection, then click on previous IDE versions, then click on add to Firefox button. Somewhere, somewhere come down, you will get add to Firefox button. Click on add to Firefox button, then click on install. That's all. Selenium IDE, you will get it. Once you install Selenium IDE, how can you come to know that Selenium IDE has been installed? Go to tools, you will find Selenium IDE here. Or else, you will get the Selenium IDE here. If you are not getting this also, go to tools, you will get the Selenium IDE. Which means that Selenium IDE has been successfully installed. Okay, now take down the notes. Open Mozilla Firefox browser, go to seleniumhq.org, go to seleniumhq.org, click on download tab, then click on download tab, then after clicking under Selenium IDE subsection, click on previous IDE version, click on add to Firefox button and restart. That's it. This is all about the installation of Selenium IDE. I have installed Selenium IDE. I'm going to start work. Take down quickly. It's not done yet. Hello. Yeah, tell me. Yeah, it support. The recently they have implemented, but it is of no use even if you do. We are not going to use this Selenium IDE anywhere. Just we are going to learn today and tomorrow, and just we are going to trash it. Next, we have installed Selenium IDE. We are going to start automating a small application like Gmail application. Wherever you see in YouTube, right, you will, there will be automating only Google login page, Google login page, Gmail login page. Why can't we try a different real-time application? We need some application, right, to automate. What the application I am going to use here is, I'm going to use an application called demo.actitime.com. That is not www.actitime.com. Don't go and go to your home and type www.demo.actitime.com or else only actitime.com or something. Just give demo.actitime.com. Don't type HTTP also. Don't do anything. Just type demo.actitime.com in your browser and hit enter so that this application will open. What is this application is all about, I will let you know in tomorrow's class. Okay. To log in into this application, username is admin and password is manager. Admin, manager. Username and password will be given here itself. If I change the username and password, I will change it here also. And click on login. It will log in into the application. I can log in into the application and I can log out of this application. What is this application is all about, we can see tomorrow. Now, I want to automate this small login process. I want to automate this small login process. How to do that? That is what I am going to do now. Okay, I have opened the browser. This is my browser, right? This is my browser. Go to tools. Just another 10 more minutes we can complete. Go to tools. Go to Selenium IDE. Go to tools and go to Selenium IDE. Here, whatever you see, this is the Selenium IDE tool. Click on the Selenium IDE, you will get the Selenium IDE tool. Your browser and Selenium IDE has been parallelly open. This is the record button. Now recording, click to stop recording. Whatever you do in the browser, that will get recorded here. That will get recorded here. I am going to do something called demo.actitime.com. I am going to open the URL called demo.actitime.com. Enter admin, enter manager, click on login. Everything this is getting recorded here, right? Line by line it is getting recorded here. See here, when I click on this login button, look here. When I click on this login button, one more line will get added because the actions, whatever I do here, that will get recorded. Now if I stop recording here, if I stop recording and if I do something, will it record? No. This is just a recording tool. Now, if I run this, close this browser, this is a run button. If I run this, I had run it, it is opening demo.actitime.com, enter admin manager, click on login, everything, it has been automated, right? A login test case has been automated here. Some sort of manual effort has been reduced. This is nothing but automation. How to write this code, all these things, we are going to see that. What I did today is, it has got failed. Sometimes, this is the application problem, not because of the script. Now if I run, it will work. It opens demo.actitime.com, enter admin, manager, click on login, it will login into the application. I have recorded and playback. That's it. This we will see in detail about. Just go home today, practice this difference between Selenium and QTP and just install it. That's it. No need to record and run also. Just install it. You will find some problem while installing. I didn't tell you what the problem you will... There is a small problem what you will find when you are installing. Try to bring out the problem whether you are able to install or not. For sure you will face the problem. Don't keep on pinging me that, sir, I am unable to install. It is showing some version problem, all those things. I didn't teach you that. What are the problems you will be finding? I taught you how to install, that's it. Tomorrow I will tell you what are the problems what you will face during the installation, all those things. If you can try to install, try to do that. Or I'll just leave it. Tomorrow I will just recap this from past 10 minutes, whatever I have did it. Then we can see in the tomorrow's class. Yeah. That we'll see tomorrow. You should not give anything. You should not touch anything here. Just start recording and do whatever you do in the browser. That will take care of everything. Giving the base URL, everything, it will take care. You don't need to do anything here. No. Stop recording. Just wait for another 5 more minutes. I want Rajalakshmi, Joshna, can you please ping your Gmail to me? That's all about...